Hello students, welcome to the class on editorial decode, and in this class I will be decoding why our universities are informant, written by Nivedita Menon. Now from examination point of view, this will help you general studies mains examination paper 2, plus this is important for sociology and public administration optional students. Now what is this editorial about? This editorial is about how the university space is being used for dissent, debate and discussion. This editorial is also about how we need to be bit more receptive to what is happening in JNU. This editorial is also about how the media is actually trying to exacerbate. It is actually trying to exaggerate the entire episode that has unfolded. Now, in order to understand this editorial, we need to go into the very basics of how society works and why the politicians are not ready to listen to what the students at JNU are talking and saying and debating about. Now, when it comes to society, society is actually arranged, it is actually structurized, it is actually crystallized in an hierarchical manner. Now, what is meant by hierarchy here? Hierarchy means you have the poor people, lower middle class, you have the people who are very destitute, then you have a section of the society that is the middle class, then you have got a section of the society that is upper class. Now, when we talk about this debate, when we talk about this discussion, when we talk about the critical analysis of anything, when we talk about dissent, when we talk about criticism, now these are the things that are more kind of associated with the lower middle class. This is something that is associated more with the poor class. This is something that the destitute people are more interested in. When it comes to the middle class, the upper middle class, the middle class and the rich class, they are actually less interested in the concepts of democracy. They are less interested in debate. They are less interested in discussion. They are less interested in the way the things should be moving towards a horizon of civilized society. Now, why the upper middle class? Why the rich class is against, is antithetical to this concept of democracy? Now, the upper class and the middle class owes their current status to the status quoism. Whatever is in existence has provided them with their economic and social status. And whatever is in existence presently in the current scenario has offered very less to the lower middle class, to the destitute class, to the poor class. Now, whatever is in existent, whatever is prevailing, whatever the current situation is like, it is either benign to one and it is malign to the other one. It is malign to the section of the society that wants to ameliorate the things, that wants to emancipate the society, that wants to reinvigorate the society, that wants to create a utopian setup, that wants to create a system which is favorable to everybody. Now, such kind of debates, discussions, criticism, it generally oozes out, it is generally secreted in the universities, it is secreted in the clubs which have a kind of intellectual mass present in them. Let me take the case of the Central Universities of India. Now, these universities are housed by the people who are not working. This is housed by the people who are constantly reflecting over whatever is happening in the society. Now, the corridors of the universities are bound by the people who wants to bring about a kind of transformation in how the India is working. Now, this is something that had unfolded in JNU. Now, the support, the criticism of whatever has happened in JNU, it is something that is embedded in the society itself. It is something that is embedded in the system itself. It is something that has to do with the entrenched interests that have got crystallized since the days of 1990s. Before 1990s, there was a kind of a hope to the people. Hope that the concept of pseudo-socialism that India was following, it might lead to the percolation of the resources to the bottom levels. But now, what is currently being manifested is that 1% of the Indian population, it owns about 49% of the resources. There is a huge level of disparity. There are people who cannot even afford to fill up their stomachs. There are people who cannot afford health facilities, basic health facilities. There are people who cannot afford basic education. And there are people who can spend around crores, millions and billions on living their life. So this editorial, if you look at it from a broader perspective, is a kind of an episode that got repeated in the American Revolution. It is something that got, it is a kind of a repetition. It is kind of replication that is taking place. So this very thing has happened in the French Revolution. This very thing had happened in the Russian Revolution. It is a kind of a descent of the society to talk on the issues like human rights, to talk on the issues like environment, to talk on the issues like bridging the disparity, reducing the hiatus, reducing the gap, reducing the chasm between the people who are earning huge, huge and huge and the people who are not earning at all. We have been more accustomed towards the conditionalities, towards the nitty-gritties, towards the finesses of the capitalist system. And it is because of that, the debate, the discussion, the criticism is something that is hatred by the middle class. It is something that is hatred by the rich class. When I'm talking about middle class, it means somebody who's earning 10 crore rupees per year. It is somebody who's earning, who's having a net worth of around 10 to 15 crore rupees. And I'm talking about lower middle class, it means somebody who is just surviving, who is just earning 20 to 30,000 rupees per month and surviving. So this is all for the editorial decode. You can subscribe to this channel. Name of the channel is EIS Mentors. You can contact me at 845-940-000 in case you're interested in buying the video class, your entire Civil Services Preparation. And in order to avail the information of the classes that we're offering, please visit our websites eiasmentors.com and brindigi.com. And in case you like this video, do click on the like button to share and comment on this video. You can also install our application. Name of the application is Brindigi. You can find that application from Google Play Store and from App Store. And you can also install the application on the MCQs. You can find that application only on the Android platform, so you can download it from Google Play Store. And please do participate in the answer writing program. So this was all for the day. Bye-bye. Take care. Have a nice day.